Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to this pre-recorded Eucharist for the fourth Sunday of Advent at St. Paul's Cathedral in Sale, on lands of which the Gunai Kurnai peoples and the Bryakalung clan thereof are the traditional custodians, and we pay our respects to their elders, past and present, and to all First Nations peoples. This will be the final of these pre-recorded offerings from the Cathedral Parish for this year, and an opportunity to thank St. Paul's for its hospitality, Dean Susanna, of course, Acting Dean Liam, and our wonderful cathedral team who make this ministry possible. We'll be having a short break over January, but we'll return with an online offering in some way, shape or form early in the new year. As we draw towards the close of another challenging calendar year, we thank you for your company with us around this table and pray that the great mystery of the Incarnation, that foundation and centrepiece of our faith, might bring you joy and hope and peace this Christmas.
We light candles of hope, peace, joy and love, remembering the promises of God with prayer. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth, then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and he shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We light this candle in hope. We light this candle in peace. We light this candle in joy. We light this candle in love. Let us pray. God, whose origin is from ancient of days, we seek your presence. Help us usher in the coming Christ child during this season of holy waiting. Come in hope, come in peace, come in joy, come in love. O come, Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength. Jesus said, "This is the great and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself." The Lord comes, bringing to light things now hidden in darkness and disclosing the purposes of the heart. Let us open our hearts and prepare for his coming, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Let us pray. Gracious God, you have visited your people and redeemed us in your Son. As we prepare to celebrate his birth, make our hearts leap for joy at the sound of your word, and move us by your Spirit to bless your wonderful works. We ask this through him whose coming is certain, whose day draws near, even your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Consequently, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offerings you have not desired, but a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sin offerings you have taken no pleasure." Then I said, "See, God, I have come to do your will, O God. In the scroll of the book it is written of me." When he said above, "You have neither desire nor taken pleasure in sacrifice and offerings and burnt offerings and sin offerings, these are offered according to the law," then he said, "See, I have come to do your will." He abolishes the first in order to establish the second, and it is by God's will that we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, once and for all. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Song of Mary. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, who has looked with favour on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. God has mercy on those who fear him from generation to generation. The Lord has shown strength with his arm and scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones and lifting up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to the aid of his servant Israel to remember the promise of his mercy, the promise made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you young among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." For the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A king comes from tiny Bethlehem. His strength will be God's, his majesty God's. His blessing will reach the ends of the earth, for he shall be called Prince of Peace. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our Redeemer. If I stand to one side, you shall see clearly the ring of four candles, which have progressively lit these last 4 weeks of Advent, beginning with a candle for hope, then peace, last week joy, and now love. We are truly, truly blessed to belong to a church that honors this season of Advent, that keeps the awe associated with it, the remembrance of the darkness before the coming of the light. As I walk around Sale, I can feel the excitement in the air. The spirit of expectation is hovering all around. I expect it's the same where you live. Something special, something significant is waiting to be touched, seen, and heard. The story of the Creator God's eternal love. As John Keble's old hymn reminds us, new every morning is the love our awakening and uprising prove. Each day is full of divine grace. Some days like Christmas and seasons like Advent draws us closer to this reality. The reading that accompanied the lighting of the fourth candle, the candle of love, was from Micah, an 8th century prophet. His oracle speaks to a world that is caught in the bewilderment of violence, uncertainty, and economic disruption. While there is much that separates us from 8th century Judah, these undercurrents are not unlike the world in which we live today. We too seek hope for security and peace. The promise of Micah is that God will be faithful and redeem his people. As Advent draws to a close, Micah invites us to look for God's presence where we least expect and to be attuned to the voices of the small, the powerless, and the vulnerable. The letter from Hebrews reminds us that God's plan involves a restoration of true order, not based on sacrifice and expensive offerings, but on God's gracious action of sanctifying each one of us as holy beings, worthy of being loved by our Savior and Redeemer. In the Gospel reading, we heard again the story of Mary's visit to Elizabeth. Did your heart, like Elizabeth's, jump within you when she heard her cousin Mary? Did your heart dance within you when we heard the words of Micah, how he shall feed his flock like a shepherd? Let me share with you a story which can be found in a book called How Then Shall We Live? By Jack Kornfield, an American teacher of Buddhism in the West. The story goes like this. It is the custom in one African tribe that when a woman decides to have a child, she goes out and sits alone under a tree and she listens. She listens until she hears the song of the child who wants to come. Once she hears the song, she returns to the man who will be the child's father and teaches the song to him. When they make love to conceive the child, they sing the song to welcome the child to them. When the woman is pregnant, she teaches the child's song to the midwives and old women of the village, so that when the birth time arrives, the people surrounding the mother sing the song to welcome the child among them. Then as the child grows up, the other villagers learn the song too. The story goes on through the life of the child. The child's song is sung at every great and small moment of the child's life. Today's gospel tells us of a pregnant woman who sings a song about her child. Who is he and who he will become? Mary's song spills out of her heart as she responds to her cousin Elizabeth's spirited greeting. It is the song of praise to God, a song of personal thanksgiving for all that God has done for both herself and her cousin Elizabeth. But it is more than that. It comes from deep inside her. It knits together in a new way the sacred experience and language and hope of her people, like pieces of a quilt transformed from offcuts to awesome splendor. However, nowhere in this song do we hear the name of Mary's child, but he is there. He is present in every phase. The song is not Mary's song alone. It is the song of the child who craves to come, who longs to come, who comes to do the will of God. The song echoes in the events of her son's life, his death, and his exaltation. The song celebrates the God who keeps promises not only to Abraham, but also to each of us. Mary's song is a song of a world turned upside down. It articulates a vision of God's kingdom on earth, where the hungry are filled and the lowest of the low are lifted up by the goodness and mercy of God. Why are the rich sent away empty and the powerful brought low? Because in their wealth they see and have no need for God. The reading from Hebrews 10 echoes the Magnificat as it speaks of the faithful, obedient action in love of the sound of this amazing song, Jesus. Our church has picked up this song and sung it often, particularly during evening worship. Mary's song, the Magnificat, is a central text in the liturgy of the historic church. Who knows what number of settings musicians have composed for it through the years? Who knows how many voices have joined with Mary in singing her song through the centuries? Another hymn to touch us at this time, written by Christina Rossetti, you can look her up on the internet, "Love Came Down at Christmas, Love All Lovely, Love Divine." The words echo the arrival of the one whose Mary's song is about. Mary's song declares God to be the God of mercy, the God of justice, and the God of hope. May Mary's song, the Magnificat, be our song as we greet our Savior who brings hope, peace, joy, and love. Let us pray. Behold, I come to do your will, not holocausts or sin offerings, but a perfect yes to God, one body, once for all. Christ, you are humankind's most sublime amen to the Father, a most wondrous gift to us. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus, come.
Let us together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the world and for the Church.
A woman waits for the birth of her first child. Tenderly and lovingly, she prepares a welcoming place for this new life. We too prepare for this coming birth. O God, we bring to you our prayers for your world. You laboured and brought forth and called the fruit of your labour good. Help us too to cherish your creation. May your new life in us be brought to birth in justice and righteousness, that the earth may be set free from destruction and death, and all your people live in freedom, safety, and peace. Jesus, Son of Mary, dwell in us, and in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring to you, God, our prayers for your church. You brought your church into being and commissioned us to bear your love to the world. Help us to be faithful to our calling. We pray for all our leaders and people in Gippsland and the wider communion throughout Australia and the world. May we be aware of the stirrings of new life within, that we may await in joyful expectation for the mystery of your coming to unfold and proclaim your glory in all the world. Jesus, Son of Mary, dwell in us, and in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring to you our prayers for all in need. At your birth, there was no room for you, and you took your place with the lowly and the poor. Help us to find room in our hearts for the lonely, the forgotten, the sick, the dying, the grieving, all in our personal heart's care. And we lay before you, Lord, those affected by and responding to the Devonport tragedy. May your presence through us transform grief, despair, and pain, that all may come to know new dignity, comfort, hope, and peace. Jesus, Son of Mary, dwell in us, and in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for your faithful people of every age, as we remember our own personal encouragers and mentors. And we especially give thanks for the trust and obedience of the Virgin Mary. O God, you know that birth is a painful experience, sometimes a fearful experience. You know that giving birth calls for effort and single-mindedness. Help us to give our attention to this coming birth. May we who wait for your coming open to you the dark and secret places of our lives. Make a place for your transforming love and rejoice when we recognize your presence. Jesus, Son of Mary, dwell in us, and in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who was looked for by the prophets, heralded by the Baptist, announced by an angel, born of the Virgin Mary, and revealed at last to men and women of every race. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine, and we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. And looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom, in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen.
And as our Saviour, Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. as this broken bread was once many grains which have been gathered together and made one bread, so may your church be gathered from the ends of the earth into your kingdom. Come, let us take this holy sacrament, the body and blood of Christ, in remembrance that he died for us, and feed on him in our hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. Let us pray. God, for whom we wait, we thank you that you have fed us with the bread of life and the cup of salvation. As we joyfully await your Son, keep us ever watchful, that we may be ready to meet him on the day of his coming. Most loving God, you send us into the world you love. Give us grace to go thankfully and with courage in the power of your Spirit. Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. In the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.